Hey, welcome to Generation X3. I'm your host, John C. Dvorak. This is a show where we have one baby boomer, myself, getting into a debate with three millennials over here on my left, and we're going to discuss a couple of stories that Dorian discovered. Of course, we've humiliated her in the meantime because this one story is obviously a hoax. Romney vows to undo everything Obama has done. Quote, I will make bin Laden alive again. Calls slain al-Qaeda leader a job creator. So what have you been smoking?
The problem with getting a job with for Osama bin Laden is you have to blow yourself up. You don't get to retire. You don't get to enjoy your retirement.
As a president, now this is a story.
He's going to bring him back.
As a president, I will immediately close down GM and Chrysler and put thousands of Americans back out on the street, he said. I will then try to get a hold of the DNA of Gaddafi. Okay.
Did you not read this?
I didn't really read it.
Wait, oh, okay. There we go.
You just saw the jingoistic headline, and you jumped right on board because you're a liberal.
But supposedly proof, this is because he said that he likes to fire people. So this is
no. That's what's the takeoff on.
Yeah.
Yeah. Supposedly he likes to fire people. So and then you followed up.
Followed up with Girl Scouts boycott cookie sale over right to pee outdoors. So people in northeastern Ohio will not be getting your Girl Scout cookies this coming spring because the Girl Scouts are boycotting over. Toilets pee. Being built in their campgrounds because apparently they like to pee outdoors and not in a toilet when they're camping. So, sucks.
You believe this story?
I believe it. I mean, well, I don't know if I believe it.
Now you're
okay. Wait. Do you think there's just like armies of Girl Scouts peeing all over the place?
No. When Girl Scouts go camping.
Have you been a Girl Scout?
Yeah.
Okay. Did you go pee in the woods?
Yes. That's what you do when you camp.
Well, you don't have to.
I know.
Where are you going to go?
I only camp at the KOA.
What's
that? I'm just kidding.
Did you read the last line? The girls may be attached, relieving themselves in comfort, but moms know making the outdoors.
Your toilet builds. They couldn't even get the
yeah, I was like, what is you toilet? Builds a character? Wow.
Okay, okay.
So apparently all of the stories that I find are bullshit.
They're fake.
They're fake.
You're attracted to...
Well, what side did you use,
but you
though?
Believe it. That's the weird part about it. Let's talk about the gullibility of you guys. Are you all gullible like this?
Well, No. Sometimes.
Of course not. I don't believe anything
everybody,
I read.
Now, everybody has been caught in one sort of internet hoax or another at one point in their life.
Of course.
It happens to everybody.
Never.
Oh, please. You don't even know.
You get the little things. Oh, there's a virus coming around. You go check this out, see if it's on your system. And you go and there's a little... My favorite one was the little teddy bear, which was actually an icon used by Microsoft for some crazy DLL. And there was a hoax that went around saying, if you see the little teddy bear, which is the indication of the teddy bear clan's virus.
I remember that.
Remember?
Yeah.
And you go there and there it was. And then if you erase it, you screwed up your system because it was an important DLL.
Oops.
And
Did you do that?
No. No, because when I see something that's suspicious like that, I always Google it. And then the Google tells me, hey, this is a hoax. And so I'm, you know, if I actually, I will say that I've gotten to the point where I could almost believe it. But then if I'm a little skeptical, I'll Google it and I'll find out that it's, but I've seen people send out the mass emailings embarrassing themselves.
I know you don't have Facebook, but every few months there's going to be everybody posting on their Facebook. If you don't copy this and send it to everybody, Facebook will delete your account, blah, blah, blah.
Well, that's the chain letter.
I know.
My favorite one of that was the, I don't know if you've seen this one, Bill Gates is secretly going to give away $1 million to a user. But you have to enter the contest.
Uh-huh. He is? Where? No.
You got to enter the contest, and it ended up flooding some guy's email box with I'm in. You know, some guy at Microsoft is flooded with emails.
He's not the richest guy in the world anymore, huh? Second.
No, I think he's still the richest.
Slim. Carlos Slim passed him.
No, that won't last.
That's how you become the richest man in the world.
Who is he?
Corruption. Mexico.
Carlos Slim.
Who is Carlos
He's a Mexican telecom guy.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, he's big. Yeah. He owns most of all the cell phone business
and drugs
all over the place. I don't think so.
No. It's just it's monopolies.
It's just a bunch of monopolies.
Yeah,
you can get rich real quick that way.
Yeah, we need to start something like that around here.
So what hoaxes have you been caught up in? Any of them?
No, really.
I know I've been caught. I just don't remember.
I've seen things on Facebook where it's like, enter here and you can win 2 free plane tickets, and so I've done it, and then it never works because you get all the way to the part where it's like, oh, that's which not magazines re- would you oh, like to
that's
subscribe
not
re- to?
That's not a hoax, a pure hoax. That is a scam. Yeah. It's different. And I've seen it before. All you have to do, you free iPad.
Yeah.
And you say, answer these questions, and you answer, and then it says, well, we've got more questions for you, and then you get, and it goes on forever, so you never, because you'll give up about 2/3 of the way through because you're sick of it.
Do you think, I mean, those ever work, ever?
No.
I think they work for doing market research. I think it's a market research scam. Nobody wants. Yeah. You don't want to pay anybody any money.
Yeah. It's a company, actually. Yeah. I forgot what they're called.
But that's not a hoax.
Tricky bastards.
Yeah, well.
Internet marketers.
Well,
apparently I bought into all of their crap, so.
Well, you bought a couple.
Well, look at his stories.
These stories are hoaxes.
Yeah.
All right.
When I camp in, I camp naked.
What?
Just let you know.
You just changed this topic for some reason?
Well, I mean, there's nothing, because I feel for the Girl Scouts, is what I'm saying.
Naked?
There's nothing more liberating than.
In the woods.
Naked.
In the woods.
Yeah.
With no shoes.
No shoes, nothing, except for my knife. I wear it on a holster.
This is bull crap.
Of course it is.
I got to smile out of Dorian. Anyway, you've been watching Generation X3.